Hey guys, Perry from Rockville here, and today I'm gonna teach you how to set up your RPM 45 powered mixer. This mixer is perfect for live performances, band rehearsals, DJ events, houses of worship, karaoke, and much more. So as you can see, it comes with the mixer itself and a power cable. The handle on top of the mixer makes it perfect to bring to any gig or event. So in setting up the RPM 45, the first thing we're gonna wanna do is take the included power cable, take the female end and plug it into the power socket on the back of the mixer. Then you'll wanna take the other end and plug it into a power outlet. Now when using a powered mixer, you're gonna wanna make sure to use passive speakers. Let me grab a couple right now and show you how to set them up. Okay, so along with my two passive speakers, I'm gonna wanna go ahead and grab two quarter inch cables to connect the speakers to the mixer. We're just gonna take one end of each cable and plug them into the quarter inch speaker output on the back of the mixer. Then we'll take the other ends of our cables and plug them into the quarter inch input on the back of the speaker. Now there's also a quarter inch line output that we can use for another speaker or mixer. There's even an effect return on the back of the mixer that we can use to connect to an external device. And there's also an RCA input that we can use for CD or tape machines, and an RCA output that we could use for a recording device. All right, so now that we've got our speaker set up, let me take you through the mixer itself. Now the RPM 45 has four mono XLR inputs for microphone use. Let me show you how to set one up right now. Firstly, you'll want to make sure that the master volume and the volume for each mic channel are all the way down, just to avoid any unwanted feedback or noise. Now you can take an XLR cable, take the female end and plug that into your microphone. Then we'll take the other end and plug that into the channel you want to use. Today we'll use channel 1. Now we can raise the volume knob on that channel. Then we can raise our master volume. And if I turn on my microphone, you should be hearing me coming out of both speakers. Now for this demo, I'm using a dynamic microphone, but we can also use condenser microphones with this mixer. You'll just want to make sure you turn on the phantom power button here to power the condenser mic. After that, we would set up the microphone the exact same way. Now we can even plug in an instrument to the RPM 45. For this, you'll want to use a quarter inch cable that you would plug into your instrument. Then you'll take the other end and plug that into the quarter inch line input on your channel. After that, raise the volume of the channel and you'll hear the instrument coming out of your speakers. All right, so now that I've got sound coming through, let me show you what we can do on each channel. So each channel is built with a two-band EQ that we can use to affect the high and low frequencies of whatever is coming through. So for example, if I want to affect the high frequencies, I'm going to use this treble knob. So if I raise it, you'll notice that my voice comes out a little clearer, and if I lower it, you'll notice that more low end comes through. Same thing with the bass knob. If I turn it up, you'll notice my voice come out a little bassier, and if I lower it, you'll notice that we start to lose that bottom end. Now each channel also comes with its own reverb knob. So if we want to add reverb to our voice or instrument, we just turn the knob up. But if we want to hear that reverb, we're going to want to make sure to go to the EFX controller and turn the volume knob up. And we can really tweak the sound of the reverb with this echo and delay knob here. So now if I raise my reverb knob on the channel, you should hear my voice coming out with the effect. Now the RPM 45 also comes with a USB input so we can play MP3s. You'll just want to be sure to raise this MP3 volume knob to hear the songs. And to hear the level coming through your CD or tape machine, you'll just want to go ahead and raise the CD tape volume knob. It even comes with a control panel here that we can use to pause, play, stop, rewind, fast forward, and even loop our tracks. So I hope this showed you guys how easy it is to set up your RPM 45 powered mixer. But of course, if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to reach our customer support team through phone or email. As always guys, I'm Perry from Rockville,
and I'll see you next time.